money. So let us solve the given model assessment sheet. So look at the board, children. Question number 1. Express given amount in short form. So here they have given few amounts in words. We have to express them in figures in a short form. So here look at the first example. 12 rupees 5 paise. So we can use here rupee symbol, rupee 12.5 paise. So you can write 0.5. So we use a point of dot to separate the paise and rupee. So after the point or after the dot, two digits represent paise. Before dot, digits represent rupees. So this is the way of writing rupees in short form. So here we are expressing rupees and paise in figure. Now look at the next one. 15 rupees 55 paise. So write the symbol of rupee. How many rupees? 15 rupees. Then insert dot to separate the rupees and paise. How many paise? 50 paise. Got it? Now look at the third example. 16 rupees 0 paise. So write the rupee symbol. Rupees, how much? 16. Then insert the dot. How many paise? 0 paise. So 16 rupees 0 paise in short form. Now look at the fourth example. 35 rupees 75 paise. So write down the rupee symbol. Then how many rupees? 35 rupees. Write in figure. Then insert the dot. How many paise? 75 paise. So next write two digits 75 paise after that dot. So we have expressed the amount in short form. So look at the next one. 65 rupees 5 paise. So you can write the rupee symbol as shown on the board. Next, how many rupees? 65 rupees. Then insert a dot to separate the rupees and paise. How many paise? 5 paise. So you can write 0.5. So 65 rupees 0 paise. So got it, children? When we have to express given amount in short form, so we have to write the given amount in figures as shown on a board. Have you got it, children? Now look at the question number 2. Write the rupee and paise in words. So here they have given the amount in figures. We have to express this in words. So look at the first one. Rupees 775 paise. So 7 rupees. Then after writing rupees, you can insert comma to separate the rupees and paise. Or you can use the word and. 7 rupees and 75 paise. So instead of using and, we will insert here comma. 7 rupees 75 paise. Got it, children? So you should write in words as shown on a board. 7 rupees, 75 paise. Now look at the second example. Rupees 4. Insert dot to separate the rupees and pence.
we can write it in figures as shown on a board. I hope everyone following it. Now look at the question number 4. Convert into rupees. So here they have given the money in paise. So we have to convert the given paise into rupees. So already you have learned. Let us recall. So what we have to do here? Yes. We have to circle two digits from right side to convert the paise into rupees. So digits which we circle, they represent paise. The digits which left or which remains, those represent rupees. So now see here, 1250 paise is there. So let us circle two digits from right side. 1, 2. So these two digits represent paise. So what remains here? 1, 2. So remaining digits represent rupees. So here rupees 12, then insert the dot to separate the rupees and paise. How many paise? 50 paise. So here we have converted paise into rupees. Got it?
So 19.0 paise. Have you got it, children? I hope you are following it. Now look at the question number 5. Convert into paise. So here they have given amount in rupee form. We have to convert this in paise. So children already have learned to convert the given rupees. You have to multiply the rupees into 100. So you will get the paise. So 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. So here you can multiply the given rupee into 100. So you will get the total paise. So here how many rupee? 9 into 100. So multiply the number other than 0. So other than 0 we have 9 here. 9 ones are 9. Then you can insert the zeros as many in the second factor. So the second factor has 2 zeros. So how many paise here? 900 paise. So to convert the given rupees into paise, we have to multiply by 100. Got it? Now look at the next example. 15 rupees. 15 rupees into 100. So multiply the number other than 0. So other than 0 we have 15 into 1. So 15 ones are 15. Then you can insert the zeros as many in the second factor. So the factor has how many zeros here? 1, 2. So here we have inserted 2 zeros. So how many paise? 1500 paise. Or you can read it 1500 paise. Now look at the next example. Rupees 24. So 24 into 100. So you can multiply the number other than 0. 24 into 1. 24 ones are 24. Then you can insert the zeros as many in the factor. So the factor has 2 zeros. So we have inserted 2 zeros. So here 2400 paise. Got it? Now look at the next example. 75 rupees. So 75 rupees into 100. Multiply the number other than 0. 75 ones are 75. Then you can insert 2 zeros. So 7500 paise. Now look at the next example. Rupees 8. So 8 into 100. 8 ones are 8. Then you can insert 2 zeros. So how many paise? 800 paise. So this is the way of converting given rupees into paise. Have you got it, children?
So it's very easy to convert. Now look at the next example, children. Find the sum. Okay?
So here they have given rupees and paise. We have to add the given rupees and paise to find the total amount. So remember, children, when you have to add the given rupees and paise, you have to follow the rules of addition which already you have learned. So when you have to add the given rupees and paise, begin your addition with paise column. So first you can add the digit in paise column. Next you can add the digits in rupees column. So let us begin. So here 9 plus 6. 9, keep in your mind, hold 6 fingers and count forward. So after 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 15 is a 2 digit number. Carrying 1 on 10th column, write down 5 in 1st column.
should follow the rules of addition which already you have learnt in previous class. So look at the next question. Find the difference. So here we have to find the difference of given rupees and paise. So here also we have to follow the rules of subtraction which you have learned already. So remember children, when you have to subtract the given rupee and paise, begin your subtraction in the paise column. First subtract the digits in paise column. Next you can subtract the digit in rupees column. So look at the board. 3 minus 8. Is it possible? No. Why? Because 3 is less than 8. So what we have to do here? Cancel 3. Borrow 1 from tens column. So it is subtraction with regrouping. So 10 1 3 months is equal to 13 ones. So write above 13 ones. Next cancel the digit in tens column. So in tens column we have 4. 4 minus 1, 3. So write above in tens column. So here we have left with 3 tens. Now you can subtract. 13 is greater than 8. So 13, keep in your mind. Hold 8 fingers and count backward. So 13 minus 8, how much? 5. So write down the difference in ones column. 3 minus 2, 1. Write down in tens column. So next you can insert the dot to separate the paise and rupees. Now 8 minus 3, 5. Write down in hundreds column. 6 minus 4, 2. Write down in thousands column. 7 minus 2, 5. Write down in 10,000s column. So what is the difference here? 425 rupees 15 paise. Got it? Now look at the next example. 307.85 paise minus 113.38 paise. So begin your subtraction with paisa column. 5 minus 8. Is that possible? No. 5 is less than 8. So cancel 5. Borrow 1 from tens column. So 10 ones and 5 ones, 15 ones. Write above in ones column. Next, cancel the digit in tens column. 8 minus 1, 7. Write above in tens column. So here we have regrouped 110 into 10 ones. Now we can subtract. 15 is greater than 8. So 15, keep in your mind. Hold 8 fingers and count backward. So already you have learned. Okay? Now look at the question number A. Add the rupees and paise. So here, they have given few examples. So the numbers are arranged in the respective column. So when you have to subtract the given rupees and paise, first arrange the given numbers in the respective column. Then you can begin your subtraction with paise. So here, we have first add the rupees and paise. So begin your action with paise column. 8 plus 0, 8. Write down in ones column. 8 plus 7, 15. So carry 1 on hundreds column. Write down 5 in tens column. Then insert the dot to separate the rupees and paise. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus carry 1, 8. So what is the total here? 8 rupees, 58 paise. Got it? Now look at the next one. Rupees 5, 76 paise plus rupees 2, 80 paise. 6 plus 0, 6. Write down in ones column. 7 plus 8, 15. Carry 1 on hundreds column. Write down 5 in tens column. Then you can insert the dot after 2 digits. Sorry, before 2 digits. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus carry 1, 8. So write down in hundreds column. So what is the sum here? 8 rupees 56 paise. Now look at the next example. Rupees 85 paise plus rupees 14 25 paise. So first add the paise. 5 plus 5 10. Carry 1 on tens column. Write down 0 in ones column. 8 plus 2 10. 10 plus carry 1, 11. So again carry 1 on hundreds column. Write down 1 in tens column. Then insert the dot. Now we can add the rupees. 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus carry 1, 13. So again carry 1 on thousands column. Write down 3 in hundreds column. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus carry 1, 6. So what is the total here? 63 rupees 10 paise. Have you got it, children? Now look at the next example. Rupees 23 75 paise plus rupees 17 25 paise. So after the dot, 2 digit, represent paise. Begin your action with paise. 5 plus 5 10. Carry 1 on tens column. Write down 0 in ones column. 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus carry 1, 10. So again carry 1 on hundreds column. Write down 0 in tens column. So here insert 1 dot to separate the rupees and paise. So before 2 digits we should insert that dot. 7 plus 3, 10. 10 plus carry 1, 11. So again carry 1 on thousands column. Write down 1 in hundreds column. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus carry 1, 4. So write down in thousands column. So what is the sum here? 41 rupees 0 paise. Got it, children? Now look at the next example. Rupees 347 25 paise plus rupees 103 25 paise. So first add the paise. 5 plus 5, 10. Carry 1 on tens column. Write down 0 in ones column. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus carry 1, 5. Write down in tens column. So before 2 digits, you can insert the dot to separate the rupees and paise. Now you can add the rupees. 7 plus 3, 10. Carry 1 on thousands column. Write down 0 in hundreds column. 4 plus 0, 4. 4 plus carry 1, 5. Write down in thousands column. 3 plus 1, 4. Write down in 10,000 column. So what is the sum here? 450 rupees 50 paise in all. Now look at the next example. the rules of addition which already you have learned. Now look at the question number 9. Subtract the rupee and paise. So here we have to follow the rules of subtraction which already you have learned. So recall the rules of subtraction and subtract the given rupees and paise. Remember children, when you have to subtract given rupee and paise, begin your subtraction with paise. So here after the dot, two digits represent paise. 5 minus 5, 0, write down in ones column. 7 minus 2, 5, write down in tens column. Insert dot. 8 minus 5, 3, write in hundreds column. 3 minus 1, 2, write down in thousands column. 3 minus 2, 1, write down in thousands, 10,000s column. So here, what is the difference? 123 rupees 50 paise. Now look at the next example. Rupees 86 25 paise minus rupees 23 16 paise. So begin your subtraction with paise. 5 minus 6 not possible, so cancel 5. Borrow 1 from tens column. 10 ones and 5 ones, 15 ones. Write above in ones column. Next, cancel the digit in tens column. 2 minus 1, 1. Write above in tens column. Now, you can subtract. Here we have regrouped 110 into 10 ones. So, 15 minus 6, 9. Write down in ones column. 1 minus 1, 0. Write down in tens column. Then insert the dot to separate rupees and paise. Next you can subtract the rupees. 6 minus 3, 3. Write in hundreds column. 8 minus 2, 6. Write in thousands column. So what is the difference here? 63 rupees 9 paise. Have you got it, children? So look at the next one. Rupees 50 0 paise minus rupees 16 50 paise. So begin your subtraction with paise column. So after the dot, two digits represent paise. 0 minus 0, 0. Write down in ones column. 0 minus 5. Is it possible? No. So cancel 0. Borrow 1 from hundreds column. So here hundreds column 0 is there. So 10. So 10 minus 1, 9. Right above it. Hundreds column. Next cancel the digit in thousands column. So in thousands column 5 is there. 5 minus 1, 4. Right above it. Thousands column. So here we have regrouped thousands into hundreds, hundred into tens. So it is subtraction with two regrouping or two borrowings. Now we can subtract. 10 is greater than 5. So 10 minus 5, 5. Write down in tens column. Then insert dot. 9 minus 6, 3. Write down in hundreds column. 4 minus 1, 3. Write down in thousands column. So what is the difference here? 33 rupees 50 paise. So have you got it, children? When you have to subtract the given rupees and paise, you have to follow the rules of subtraction which already you have learned. Okay, so children, now it's time to end our today's class. So remaining things we will discuss in our next class. You can take